that actually need a lot of attention because it has a major effect on your network. Where mainly at this side, we would really succeed if we go to the other one, where everything is automated, where every manual job is automated, and only you leave the intelligence part to your analyst to take decisions. And once you're confident, remember this VPN compromise case study that we did, once you're confident about it, you could automate it. And instead of wasting an hour minimum on one VPN account, a minute would be spent by a machine, not you, to fix it. We're here, and if you need any more help, if you need any more details, I'd be more than happy to answer your questions. Thank you.
Thank you, Sami. The next speaker is Gilles Loridon, the Chief Executive Officer of Global Security Network. He's going to touch upon another interesting subject, which is bridging the gap between SCADA, ICS, and corporate IT. We also have a dedicated discussion about cybersecurity in the energy sector at 1 p.m. today. So probably some of the things that Gilles would cover today might add on to the discussion later. So can we all please welcome Gilles?
Good afternoon. Today we will talk about how to bridge the gap between your SCADA and your IT network, between your operating technology and your IT technologies. First of all, who are we? We are a French company. I'm pretty sure you guessed by my accent that we are French. We are based in the Middle East since 1999. We do only cybersecurity. We do nothing but cybersecurity. And we do solution consulting and training as well. So, few words about us. What we would like to talk to you about today is how to bridge the gap between your usually physically separate network where you have your critical infrastructure, your ICS, your DCS, your SCADA network, and your IT corporate network, which unfortunately is connected to internet and all the bad guys sitting in some difficult to name countries in Eastern Europe or somewhere else. This is a major issue for all critical infrastructure. All critical infrastructure have mostly air gap network where they have physical separation from any other network. So you want to keep the level of security from the air gap where you have no connection whatsoever with outside, but you still need to communicate data out of your critical infrastructure. You need production data, statistical data, fault, alert, and you want to take this data from your OT network, your ICS, SCADA network, and bring them to your IT network. So this is the business case, how you can do this without compromising security. So what we would like to see is what can you do today? What is in the market today? What type of technology are in the market to achieve this? So first of all, I represent the classical seven layer of network from the physical layer up to the application layer. The usual solution is the air gap. Air gap or sneaker net, I will go into a little bit more detail, where you have no connection whatsoever. Then you have the firewalls, a very mature technology. We have many vendors in the next room selling firewalls. And just for the sake, I will change. And they are from layer 2 to layer 7. They are from the usual deep packet inception up to the best vendor. They are application aware. And they will look into the application itself and be able to filter from the application protocol. And you have a new, relatively new technology called the data diode sitting at layer 1, at the physical layer of the network. So we'll go through all the technology and see their plus and negative points, pro and cons. Who thinks that air gap network are secure? Who thinks that I would like a little bit of interaction with the room, even if I don't see you very well because of the light. Who thinks that air gap are secure? Air gap network are secure. Nobody thinks that air gap network are secure. Who thinks they are insecure? A little bit of show of hands. Thank you, gentlemen. Yes, they are. In fact, they are insecure. We have customers, unfortunately, We call them the museum of viruses. They have more viruses on their air-gap network than on Internet. They have viruses from the early 90s that do not exist anymore on Internet. It's still on their network. Why? Because they are air-gapped, so they never update the antivirus, they don't update Windows, they don't update their software, their DCS CADA software, and they are extremely vulnerable to attacks. I'm sure you are very well aware about Stuxnet, the DCS virus who attacked uranium enrichment facility in Iran. They were air-gapped, but the people got inside the facility anyway and destroyed 2,500 centrifuges. It was a major attack on an air-gapped network. So yes, you are air-gapped, you have no connection whatsoever, but it's not because you are not connected that you are not sensitive to attacks. Plus, you need media. You need USB, CD-ROMs, or hard drive to copy the information from one network to the other. You can lose the CD-ROM, you can lose the hard drive. You don't know what happened, and it's not real-time. This is heavily depending on your human being copying physically the data from one network to the other. The other solution, everybody is very familiar with it, firewall. This is a technology we use for the last 25 years or so. This is a very mature market, there is a lot of players. Who thinks that firewall are secure? Any show hand? Little bit? Who thinks that firewall are extremely insecure? Little bit also, yeah, some show hand. Just for the fun, and I'm not trying to attack any vendor, I'm trying to stay polite, but I pull out the vulnerability for one vendor, and this is many, many pages of vulnerability. This is only the first page, and up to, I don't see, even, up to here, it's 2015. Up to here, this is only for 2015, after it's 2014. So this is only for the first 6 months of the year, vulnerability discovered on this particular firewall. And some of them are really serious. 7.5, 7.5, 7.86. You have remote access, you can still login and password for the administrator, you can shut down remotely the firewalls, change the configuration. This is very small font and its own design. I don't want to be rude to the vendors. But this is another vendor, and also, this is one of the major ones. This is only the first page of vulnerability on their main firewall, where you can also get login, administrative access, remote reboot. You can change the ROM of the firewall remotely. So firewalls are not secure, far from it. Why? Because they have software. They rely on operating systems, they rely on software logic to filter the traffic, yes or no. If there is software, it can be hacked. This is as simple as that. We cannot secure software properly. And what guarantee do you have there is no backdoor in your firewall? Quite a big issue. Thanks to Snowden, we have a good idea now of the backdoor in some systems, and only from one specific country. But believe me, there are many, many backdoors in most of the systems. So what do we propose? We propose an alternative to these technologies. We propose a physical device called a data diode. The data diode is a physical hardware, is a pure hardware without logic or firmware. Fiber optic in, fiber optic out. It's physically impossible to send data the other way. It's a one-way device to guarantee that the data goes only from A to B and that it's impossible to go from B to A. This is the only product in the world certified EAL 7 plus to the common criteria. Everybody's familiar with the common criteria? Yes, no, yes, a little bit. This is an international organization which certified all security products, all firewalls, all antiviruses, all switches, router, you name it, VPN, accelerators. They are certified by the common criteria. A typical firewall is certified 4 plus. We are the only device certified AL 7 plus. Why we are the only one? Any idea why we are the only one? Yes, because no software, only pure hardware. So how does it work? In the middle, you have the diode, and you have your upstream and downstream server, left and right. You can only send data from the left to the right. It's impossible to send data the other way. Why? Because there is no receiver. If you beam light to the right side of the picture, there is no receiver. So you cannot receive any data. Data goes only one way. You can do whatever you want. You can send light, you can send photon, you can send electromagnetic information. It will not go through because there is no receiver part. So it's physically impossible to send data backward. A typical application of this technology will be to bridge the gap between your plant network, your ICS, DCS network, and your corporate IT. Corporate IT is quite of sensitive to attack because you are connected directly to internet, and you want at no point whatsoever the plant to be able to send attack viruses to your plant. But you still need to bring data, production data, statistical data from your plant to your corporate network. So it's a very good application of the diode. It's a one-way, business logically one-way communication between your plant and your corporate IT. So at the edge of your two network, you can put the diode between the edge of the two network, send data from plant, from the ICS, DCS, SCADA, to the corporate, purely one way. It's physically impossible to send data back. Anybody see a problem with this? Sorry? Excellent. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. No network protocol is one way. All network protocols are two way. The TCP/IP stack, sorry, is a two-way stack. You have to have communication both ways. So the diode, you cannot use it. I will be out of business very soon, and I think I need to find something else. But in fact, we have translator of protocol. Upstream and downstream, we have translator of protocol. We establish the TCP connection up to the black proxy, send data one way without network connection, purely data channel to the red proxy on the right side of the picture. The red proxy takes the information, put it back into TCP/IP stack. So there is no network connection between black and red proxy, but we have only a channel, data channel. We send data across, there is no connection at the network layer. You cannot ping from the plant to the corporate. You cannot ping from the corporate to the plant. Why? Because no TCP/IP connection. No network protocol will work across the diode. We can only send data through the physical layer on the fiber optic itself. So this is very good in terms of security because this is extremely good security. We are sure to achieve 100% one-way connection, but the consequence is it doesn't work for everything. So this is a list of protocols that we support by default from the box. We can do OPC to OPC, we can do Pi to Pi, OSI Pi, or we can do OPC to Pi. You can have your Pi server on your corporate network and your RTUs and all your PLC and send through OPC to the Pi server on your corporate network. We can even do put a diode between a slave and a master on Modbus type protocol. When you have a remote RTU, you have somewhere offshore, somewhere in the desert, a remote sensor, and you need to get that data to your PLC, to your master, and we can have a slave master diode where we take the data for the RTU one way. We can do one way database replication for Oracle database, SQL Server database, MySQL Server, with one read and write database on the left side and a read-only database replicated by the diode. We can transfer files through FTP, SFTP, network share, Samba. We can email a file across the diode. You can send email, you will not be able to reply, but at least you can receive your email. We can do syslog, you can have many sites. Pull the syslog for your site into your main control room and monitor your network for one single location through syslog through the diode. We can update your antivirus and your Windows server through the diode. And we have a queue system compatible with MQ or RabbitQ if you need to send messages through the diode as well with typically MQ or HabitQ systems. And worst case scenario, if nothing works, we can do raw TCP streaming one way through the diode UDP, typically for CCTV system. It's a native application. You can put directly the CCTV network through the diode to your main monitoring center, main monitoring room. It's a fairly new technology. It's available in the Middle East since 2010. It's mostly used by critical infrastructure, electricity, water production. The nuclear plant in Abu Dhabi will use this technology. And it's also used, but the other way around, for Ministry of Interior, Ministry of Defense, or Central Bank to protect their most confidential network. But in the other configuration, when you have your secret network and you take data into your secret network, but you let nothing goes out, purely one way from outside to inside. No questions? Yes, directly, because CCTV is UDP. So from a logic perspective, it's one way. So it can be put directly on the diode one way to your main control system. I'm available. Our booth, Global Security News booth, is at the end next to the coffee. And I would be more than willing to answer your question. Thank you very much.
I see there were a few hands raised. I'd like to repeat. Any questions that you have from Gilles' presentation or the other presenters, they're all available at the networking area. Please feel free to meet with them. They're here the entire day today as well as tomorrow, and they'd be happy to answer all your questions. Now, the next presenter is Jim Yeager. He's the Chief Cyber Services Strategist from Fidelis Cybersecurity. Jim is a former Brigadier General in the United States Air Force, and his military services includes stints as the Director of Intelligence for the U.S. Atlantic Command, Assistant Deputy Director of Operations.